Happiness is inside of you. So you get to the point where you start to understand this. There's two directions we can go in, and we'll do both. One is, what is the probability that you're going to get what you want? I have found, I've been doing this for 50 years, all right? And I'm very successful in the worldly sense, people say, right? But what is the probability that the moments in front of you are going to match what you want? It's very small. You're sitting on a tiny planet, spinning around in the middle of outer space. You did not make the planet. You did not make the sun. You did not make any of the things in the universe. You didn't make the environment around you. You didn't make the ground. You didn't make, you have, what, 25 trillion cells within your body. You didn't make those. You say you had a baby. You didn't make the baby. There was this one cell got fertilized, and it knew how to grow into a baby. So life is happening by itself. That's what's happening. You are not in control of all this. If you took a list, I know we like to think that we're powerful people. If you took a list and wrote down what you're in control of, and then wrote down what you're not in control of, which is everything, every other person. If you were married to somebody and they go to work, they come back different because they had a different experience. And you had a different experience. And yet you think that you have control over all these things. It's not true. The truth of the matter is you have control over very, very little of what's going on. So how are you going to be happy by getting the moments in front of you to be the way you want? And what you're going to find out, and you all are there, you wouldn't be at the seminar, is that's not going to do it. You can meditate, you can do different things to reach a state inside yourself, which is nicer, but what happens when you come out? What happens when you deal with the world? What happens when you deal with business? What happens when you deal with relationships? People have not learned how to be unconditionally happy. They're conditionally happy, and they honestly believe that getting what they want is the way to be happy. So let's just jump real quickly, because you guys are very advanced, you wouldn't be at the seminar, and say, okay, wouldn't I be happier if I liked everything? What if my preference, I came up with one preference, all right? That is, I prefer that it be the way it is. What if you liked all the weather, instead of just liking certain climates and certain humidities? No matter what the weather is, cold, I love the cold, I love to bundle up. It's hot, I love the heat, oh my God, I feel so open. Then you would not be making yourself unhappy because there are different situations that are happening in your life. You're the one who decides what the weather needed to be, which has nothing to do with what the weather is going to be. The weather is based on meteorology, not based upon your thought processes or your preferences. So you finally get to the point where you realize there's work to do outside, which is attempting to get the world to match what I want. But there's work to do inside, which is questioning how I came up with what I want. And is that really what I want? That's why I started the discussion by saying, what you really want is to be happy. So why did you qualify that by saying, I can only be happy if I get what I want? I can only feel love, tremendous love, if the person I'm with is treating me the way I want, and being the way I want, and thinking the way I want, et cetera, et cetera. Because that's not true. That's called conditional love. There is unconditional love, which exists inside of every single one of us. There's unconditional happiness, unconditional joy. And to jump again very quickly with you guys is, what is stopping me from feeling unconditional joy, unconditional love, and unconditional happiness? And the answer is you. You have built within your psyche, within your mind, the concept that I can only be happy if certain things happen. I can only feel love in certain circumstances. Why did you do that? Why not be more open? It's sort of like when you decide that you want something, you have limited what can make you happy to that thing versus all the other things that could possibly happen will make you happy. So you're just limiting yourself to a tiny little world, a tiny slice, that things have to be exactly the way you want in order for you to do what? Open. That's the key. In order for me to be open, use that word. You meet somebody, you say, oh, I felt so open with him and her or her. I'm so open about this new job. What do you think? You all talk about passion. What is passion? That you're open to the experience you're having. Then you feel all this joy. You feel all this passion well up inside of you. Why can't you feel that all the time? Wouldn't that be nice? Wouldn't it be nice to wake up in the morning and here's your attitude. I'm back. Well, I wonder what's going to happen today. This will be a lot of fun. I don't care. It's just going to be fun. I'm going to do my best at whatever's happening, and I'm going to interact with everybody and meet different people. You can do that. But if you limit yourself to what your preferences are, then you can only be happy with the things that match your preferences. So spirituality is not about renunciation of the outside world. Spirituality is about working on yourself to be more open. The more open you are, the more joy you feel. And you become completely open, unconditionally open, like the Dalai Lama, these really great beings. They just say it's about being happy. And so despite these terrible things that happen in the world, I'm going to start off by being open and not closing myself. Then I will do what I can to help. It's not that you don't come into the world. If you're filled with joy and filled with love, you're a blessing on this planet. You're a rarity. Whoever you meet is lifted. I mean, look, every single thing you resist, the car in front of you is driving slower than you want. It's hotter than you want it to be. Somebody said something, at least you think they did, that you might not like. Every single one of those, you are resisting the experience that you're having, and that resistance builds up inside of you. And that resistance is what blocks your energy. And that's the bottom line of learning. You can do all the techniques you want, when said and done, as long as you are doing that, you will never reach unconditional happiness. Why? Because you said so. You said, I don't want this to have happened. And that becomes a really interesting discussion. I purposely stuck in the word to have happened. It already did happen, but I don't want it to have happened. You tell me how that works out. Reality wins. It actually took place. Like we're talking about things you did that happened in your past that you pushed away, you resisted. And when you resisted them, they built up and they blocked your energy. You can't change your past. No one has ever changed their past. You need a time machine to go back. All you can do is deal with how you dealt with your past. And right now, you keep pushing it back down. If you had a bad experience, you're not doing well, something reminds you of the bad experience, you get uncomfortable. And so you push that back down. She said her favorite line in the book is, the moment in front of you is not bothering you. I repeat that. The moment in front of you is not bothering you. You are bothering yourself about the moment in front of you. Oh, true or not, okay? The weather's not bothering you. You're bothering yourself about the weather. The driver in front of you is not bothering you. You're bothering yourself about the driver in front of you. Every single thing, it comes in. You don't have to bother yourself about it. You can accept it. You can let it pass through and then deal with it. Nobody's saying you don't deal with life, but you don't deal with it as a way of making yourself okay. You don't deal with it as a way of manipulating it so that when it comes in, it doesn't bother me. That's just about you. That's selfish. Okay? And that's how we live our lives. And that's why we have to get the world the way we want it to be happy. Because we stored too much stuff in here. And if the world is different than the way we want it, we get upset. We get disturbed. And we think about the future, right? What's the future hold? Well, if it holds what we don't want, you get concerned and you worry about it. But the main thing I like to point out, because you're very intelligent people, is the thing about the past. Have any of you stored bad experiences you had in the past inside of you? Do you notice that they come back up in your dreams, when somebody talks to you? It stimulates this stuff, and the next thing you know, you're uncomfortable. About what? About your past. Well, why would we keep that inside of us? We can't change it. So this is what you start to understand true spirituality is. You just look at it and you say, what is the benefit of having stored stuff from 20 years ago that's still inside of me? And the answer is none. There's no benefit at all. The only reason it's in there is because I can't handle it. I couldn't handle it when it happened, and I can't handle it now. And you start building this collection of what we call samskaras, impressions, blockages, that you now have to live your life in a way that doesn't hit those. And you're based away. Wouldn't it be fun? Look, you all like stars. Do you realize you're circling around a star that's hot enough to where you feel its presence? So you have the right to do things inside yourself besides complaining, besides pushing away the experiences because they don't match your preferences. And you'll find that if you do that, all of a sudden, it's fun. And now when it gets hot, you think about a star floating out there in outer space. And that's one star. There's 300 billion in your galaxy. And all of a sudden, it starts raising you. The sun can be like a mantra. Because it's hot, it reminds you to bring up the most spiritual part of your being. You can do it anytime you want. The flow has a source. I wonder what the source of that is. We talked about what happiness is, feeling that flow. What is the source of that flow? And that becomes real spirituality. I talk about the high states that the great ones go to. You start to seek the source of this beautiful flow you feel, and it starts to pull you into it like a vacuum cleaner. It just pulls you up. It's hard to not go with it, all right? The great masters like Meher Baba and others, Meher Baba specifically said, the first time he reached the state of enlightenment, of total openness, his consciousness had been a drop of water looking at himself. All of a sudden, that drop fell into the ocean. Find it. Find the drop. You'll never find it again. That's what Christ meant by my Father and I are one. That's what's meant by merger. That's the high states. Every single one of you has that going on inside of you right now. And then instead of getting into the energy shift or what to do about it, my first act is, okay, I am the experiencer, not the experienced, and I'm willing to experience the experience, and I will just relax from the place I'm experiencing. You tell me, Tony, whether that makes sense to you.
Yes, it does.
There's a place I'm experiencing from, right?
Yes.
Rather than getting involved in the object of consciousness, I relax into the source, the seat of consciousness. Yeah. I didn't master ever feel anger. And I was shocked by his answer. He said, yes, but it's like riding on water. It just passes through. What's the difference then, right? It doesn't express itself. So that's what starts to happen, is you've been around the block enough times to understand the heart can hurt because somebody did something, somebody you're close with didn't do what you expected, right? Or somebody died that you were very close with. It should hurt. It's natural. You understand that? If somebody dies that you loved, don't giggle, make believe you're happy, right? Instead, you look at it and you say, thank you, heart, for playing a tune that's in harmony with the situation. I feel loss. I feel some pain. That's like saying, I love you. That's what I think that it means when you hurt because somebody died. Well, that's wonderful to say, I love you, but you're okay. You're not fighting it. You're not resisting it. You're not hating it. You're not afraid of it, right? There's a key, right? I'm afraid of this pain, but how will I be? You just relax through it, and you relax, and you welcome its right to play the tune it should be playing. So I'm so glad you asked that. People so misunderstand. Being happy, unconditionally happy, does not mean that you don't feel human things.
Yes.
It means you honor and respect the aspect of your being that's human, and it has this humanness, and then it's clean. It helps cleanse, right? So somebody dies, you feel lost. Right? Somebody does something you didn't expect, you feel a little uncomfortable, trust and this and that. And you smile like a child. You smile at the child, it's okay. But you know, what will it be like when that's not there? What will my life be like when I don't have that in my heart to cause all this trouble? And look at it that way, and then be grateful that you have this opportunity, step by step, right, to let go of yourself. But don't judge. No shame, no blame, just growth. Sure.